Hello, welcome students. In previous video, we have started lesson number 17, man-made materials. Now, today we are going to study the remaining part of the lesson. Students, can you tell which material is wrapped around the atoms of glass or similar material during transport to prevent from breaking up? So, the plastic bubble wrap or thermocol is used to protect fragile atoms from the shocks and breaks during their transport. Now we'll study about thermocol. Thermocol is a form of a complex material called polystyrene. It transforms into liquid state on heating at more than 100 degrees C temperature and returns to solid state on cooling. Due to this, we can give any desired shape to it. Being a good shock absorber, it is used in packing of delicate items. Adverse effects of excessive use of thermocol on environment and human. First one, being carcinogenic. Carcinogenic means which can cause cancer. So, being carcinogenic ingredients in stearine means this stearine is present in thermocol and which can cause cancer. The person in contact with thermocol for long duration may have the possibility of blood cancer like leukemia and lymphoma. Next, non-biodegradable. It takes long duration for natural degradation of thermocol, hence many people opt for destroying it by burning. However, it is still more hazardous method. Hazardous means dangerous method, as it releases poisonous gases in atmosphere. Next, in mass gatherings, plates and cups used to offer the food, water, tea are made up of thermocol. It affects the health. If the food kept in thermocol is reheated, stearine may dissolve in that food. Due to this, there is possibility of health problem. Next, effect on persons working in thermocol factory. Persons staying in contact with thermocol for long term develop the problems of eyes, respiratory system, skin, digestive system, etc. Pregnant women may face the miscarriage. Liquid stearine may cause skin burns. Make a list of glass items of daily use. Glass of which different colors is used in those items? The glass items used in our day-to-day life are spectacles, glasses used for drinking, cups, saucers, plates, bowls, mirrors, lenses, etc. Glasses of spectacles are transparent, but that of goggles is dark. Medicine bottles have amber colored glass. Red or green blue colored glasses are in decorative items. Now we'll study about glass. We use the glass material on large scale in our daily life. Glass was discovered by chance. Some Phoenician traders were cooking in desert. The cooking vessels were supported on limestones. When the cooking vessel was kept off the limestone, they observed that a transparent material has been formed. They thought that this transparent material may have been formed due to heating together of sand and limestone. This led to the development of technique of glass production. Glass is a non-crystalline, hard, but brittle solid material formed from mixture of silica and silicate. Silica, that is SiO2, to which we refer to as sand. Depending upon the proportion of silica and other components in the glass, there are different types of glass as soda lime glass, borosilicate glass, silica glass, and alkali silicate glass, etc. Production of glass. For glass production, mixture of sand, soda lime, and small quantity of magnesium oxide is heated in furnace. Furnace means bhatti. That is enclosed structure in which material can be heated to very high temperature. Sand, that is silicon dioxide, melts at 1700 degree C. So as to melt the mixture at low temperature, pieces of discarded glass are added to it. Due to this, mixture melts at 850 degree C. Once all the ingredients of mixture are liquefied, it is heated up to 1500 degree C and immediately cooled. Due to sudden cooling, mixture becomes homogeneous, amorphous, and transparent instead of crystalline. Properties of glass. On heating, glass becomes soft and can be molded into any shape. Density of glass depends upon its ingredients. Glass is slow conductor of heat. On quick heating of cool glass or on quick cooling of hot glass, it cracks or breaks. Being bad conductor of electricity, glass is used as insulator in electric appliances. Being transparent, most of light passes through the glass. However, if there are oxides of either chromium, vanadium, or iron in the glass, large amount of light is absorbed in glass. Types of glass and uses. First one, silica glass. This is produced by using the silica. Items made up of silica glass show minimum expansion on heating. It is not affected by acid and alkali. Due to this, silica glass is used to produce laboratory glass wares. Second, borosilicate glass. Borosilicate glass is produced by melting the mixture of sand, soda, boric acid, and aluminium oxide. This glass does not show any effect on medicines. Hence, the bottle made up of borosilicate glass are used in pharmaceutical industry to store the medicines. Third one, alkali silicate glass. Alkali silicate glass is produced by heating the mixture of sand and soda. As this glass is soluble in water, it called as water glass. Fourth one, lead glass. Lead glass is produced by melting the mixture of sand, soda, limestone, and lead oxide. Being very clear or transparent, it is used in manufacturing of light bulbs, tubes, etc. Fifth one, optical glass. Optical glass is produced from the mixture of sand, soda, limestone, barium oxide, and boron. This type of pure glass is useful in production of spectacles, lenses, microscopic lenses, etc. Sixth one, colored glass. Soda lime glass is colorless. So as to impart a desired color, oxide of specific metal is mixed during manufacturing process. Example, ferrous oxide is mixed to get bluish green glass and copper oxide to get red glass. Seventh one, processed glass. So as to improve the quality and utility, some processing is performed on glass and various types like reinforced glass, plain glass, fiber glass, fan glass, translucent glass, etc. are produced. Effect of glass on environment. While glass production, mixture needs to be heated up to 1500 degree C. During this, greenhouse gases like sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, carbon dioxide are released through burning of fuel. As the glass is non-degradable, if pieces of the waste glass material flow into water body, it may affect that ecosystem. Similarly, drainage may be blocked due to these pieces. I hope you understood the topic. So for better understanding, read the topic once again and do the given homework.